Today's topic is analysis of cash flow statement. In the first lecture, we have discussed cash flow statements and financial statements as in revised format as per Companies Act 2013. In the second part, we are going to discuss various tools and techniques of analysis of financial statements. Main branches of accounting are financial accounting, cost accounting, and management accounting. Financial accounting deals with recording business transactions and preparing final accounts to measure financial performance and financial position of the business at the end of every accounting period, where cost accounting deals with calculating cost per unit of goods manufactured and services rendered. Management accounting uses data of cost and financial accounting for the purpose of analysis of business performance for the purpose of decision making. Analysis of financial statement is an exercise of management accounting for the purpose of analysis and decision making for management and other stakeholders. As it is an analysis of financial performance and position for decision making of its user, it is purely voluntary in nature. Let's discuss it in detail. Concept of financial statements. As per Section 2, Subsection 40 of the Companies Act 2013, financial statements in relation to a company includes, first, a balance sheet as at the end of the financial year, second, a statement of profit and loss for financial year, third, cash flow statement for the financial year, fourth, a statement of changes in equity if applicable, and fifth is explanatory notes. Moving further to concept of financial analysis. Financial analysis is the analysis of financial statements with the help of various tools for financial analysis. To assess the business or project from the viewpoint of viability, stability, profitability, liquidity, and solvency according to some definite plan. Let us discuss commonly used tools for financial analysis. First is comparative statements. Second, common size statements. Third is trend analysis. Fourth, ratio analysis. And last is cash flow analysis. Let us discuss each tool for financial analysis in detail. First is comparative statements. When financial statements, figures for two or more years are placed side by side to facilitate comparison, these are called comparative financial statements. It draws conclusions about the profitability and financial health of the business. Such statements shows absolute figures of various years. It also indicates increase or decrease in the figures from one year to another in percentage form in separate columns. It provides opinion regarding the progress of the enterprise. When financial statements of two or more years of the same firm are presented and compared, it is known as inter-period comparison or intra-firm comparison. When financial statements of two or more firms are compared over number of years, it is known as inter-firm comparison. Now, let us understand comparative analysis with the help of a practical example. Balance sheets of Beta Limited as at 31st March 2015 and 2014 is given, and you are asked to convert them into comparative balance sheet and analyze the same. Its analysis is, the company has increased the shareholder funds and reduced outside liabilities, which ensures solvency and financial soundness. The company has increased tangible fixed assets and cash equivalent substantially and reduced intangible assets and inventories. It also shows growth in productive assets. Comparative income statement or profit and loss account can also be prepared in the same manner. Second is common size statement. In these statements, various figures are converted into percentages to some common base. In balance sheet, total assets are taken at 100 and all assets are expressed as percentage of the total assets. While in case of profit and loss account, net revenue from operations is taken as 100 and all other income and expenses are expressed as percentage of net revenue from operations. This type of analysis is called vertical analysis since each accounting variable is analyzed vertically. Let us understand common size statement with a practical example. Balance sheets of Alpha Limited as at 31st March 2015 and 14, and you are asked to convert them into common size balance sheet and analyze the same. Its solution is, here we can see the common size balance sheets of Alpha Limited. Analysis. Compared to 2013 and 14, during the year 14-15, percentages of reserves to total liabilities is increased while it is decreased in case of long-term borrowings, which shows that long-term solvency is improved. Percentage of non-current investment to total assets is increased to 36%, which indicates inability of the management to deploy the funds in the business activities. Third is trend analysis. Trend analysis allows to predict what can happen in the business in future. Trend analysis is based on historical data about financial performance of an individual item or related items of the financial statements. Change in percentage or absolute figures are calculated for a considerable long period of past, which helps to predict future performance. Let us understand trend analysis with a practical example. Analyze the trend of number of customers and sales at last 10 years of Gamma Limited. Its analysis is, the graph shows that sales increase more proportionate than increase in the number of customers. Hence, more growth in sale can be expected in future. The trend can also be assessed by calculating percentage change every year compared to the previous year. Fourth is ratio analysis. The ratio expresses relationship between two accounts taken from financial statements in meaningful manner. An analysis of business from the viewpoint of liquidity, solvency, profitability, and activity with the help of various ratios is known as ratio analysis. Let us see the classification of ratios. Let's summarize it. Financial statements are accounting information which includes profit and loss, balance sheet, cash flow statement, statement of change in equity, and notes to the accounts. Analysis of financial statements can be done by various tools. financial analysis helps to assess financial performance and financial position of the firm. Both inter-firm as well as intra-firm analysis can be made through financial analysis. It also helps to forecast future financial performance. Financial analysis suffers from certain drawbacks of financial statements. Today in this lecture, we have studied various tools used for financial analysis like common size statement, comparative statement, trend analysis, and ratio analysis. Thank you.